drawing for these tickets is for tonight, so we're gonna find out what happens in this vlog. Top of the morning, friends and family. How are you wonderful, beautiful people doing out here today? Whew. My hands are frigid from flying that drone, man. We are on our way to Freedom Breeder today, and then we're gonna check out some really cool snakes there, go see my buddy Ed, help him cut some paper, and then we're gonna go see my parents. I haven't seen them for a while, and maybe go on a little hike. I don't know, it's just a road trip, guys, it's a road trip. Let's go. Welcome to Music Monday. So every time I take this little road trip, I stop at this place, this gas station on this road called Pinocho Road. Literally every time. I've never not stopped at this gas stop. I even time my water consumption. I think the fact that it's called Pinocho Road like tickles my little middle school fancy of, you know, humor, childish humor. But when I stop here, I always grab a couple of lottery tickets. I do like to play the lottery from time to time, basically when I stop here at this gas station. And I've got plans for these tickets if they win. They're kind of selfish plans, we'll talk about that in a little bit. I honestly thought there were gonna be way more things around here that said FedEx, but you gotta do what you can with what you're given. And speaking of giving, hey Jimmy, if somebody gave you a lottery ticket, a winning lottery ticket, what would you do with the money?
Buy a lot.
No!
Oh my God.
What'd I do with it?
No, you already gave your answer.
But I have no words for that.
I'm trying to shoot some video with Jesse, but I don't know where Jesse went to. He's gone. He disappeared. It's par for the course around here. The guy is always running around trying to do a million things. How many of those million things do you think he gets done?
Two?
Well, it's better than nothing. So I told you guys we'd look at some snakes. Check this out. This is a... Jimmy, what is this?
It is a
Coroglow
Super Stripe.
Coroglow Super Stripe Possible Enchi. Check that out, man. I like it a lot. Jimmy just made a good point about people trying to cram way too many genes into their snake combos.
Instead of trying to hit it out the home run, what do they say in baseball? Just base hits wins the game. That's a base hit. Look at that. Simple genetics. I like that. You don't always have to hit it out of the park. Simplicity.
Coroglow
Lesser Calico. This thing is just smoking.
This is a cinnamon enchi pinstripe. It's got some of my favorite qualities when the alien heads become very obviously separate from the rest of the snake, and then when they run together down the side like this too and all become one. Really cool. Cinnamon Coroglow Genetic Stripe Possible Mojave. It's very
orangey,
peachy, keen.
We're naming it peach.
We're naming it peach? What kind of peach?
The juicy peach.
Juicy peach. That's the name of this morph. The juicy peach morph. It's like a scrub python. Oh, it's finally my dream of getting morphs into scrub pythons. There we go. Just turn ball python into... Give ball pythons scrub python.
How dare you, sir?
No, I'm just trying to get scrub pythons to have morphs like ball pythons.
Is there morphs of scrubs?
No, there's like patternless. Yeah, they can get pretty big, especially the king horn eye out of Australia. There's like the biggest pythons in Australia. So don't tell anybody, we had this snake on the Freedom Breeder channel last week, and we said it was a Mojave Fire. But it's really... a Mojave Fire Calico. Don't tell anybody. If somebody gave you a winning lottery ticket for like, say, $5 million, what would you do with the money?
I would, oh gosh, I don't know. I would go on vacation, buy a house, new car, I don't know. All right. Donate money.
Okay, those are all good things. I'm down with that. I'm down with that.
So today we're going to talk about normals. Characteristic. We're going over characteristics. Thank you for watching this video on identifying characteristics of ball pythons.
Well, we just finished a nice Freedom Breeder episode. Look at this beautiful backdrop I made. I forgot to ask Jesse the lottery question, and now he's gone already. We missed him. Guy is tough to nail down. But we got to run, get over to the bay, get up to Ed's place, film up that flat. Let's go! But we're here at Ed's shop. We're gonna, if you guys watch the channel, then you know Ed. We are going to do a little filming here to show how he produces his paper and the cutting process and make a little video about that. And I'll put some B-roll from that into this video too. But first, so we're on our way here and Ed says, okay, after this building, turn left, and that's where my shop's at. And I see the building and I stop. And I say, dude, what is this building? And he says, I had a dream like in the last couple months where these guys kind of detained me, basically, arrested me. They were like plainclothes officers of some type. And this is a vivid dream, a vivid enough dream that I told Hillary about it when I woke up. And they took me to this place, they took me to their station, and I had some information that they needed to know. And basically they couldn't get it out of me, and I ended up just walking out of the station. But the thing is that building, when I stopped at that building, Ed said turn left of the building, I stop. And I said, what is that place? He said, oh, that's the new sheriff's building.
Yeah, the sheriff's department, new jail.
And that's where I was in my dream. Literally, it was that building, perched up on the little hill with a little, it was the exact building from my dream. I've never had that experience before in my life. And I'm a little bit shaken by it, but it's tripping me out. It's tripping me out. And I just kind of, I wanted to know from you guys, if any of you have had an experience like that, where you went to a place that you had been to before in a dream, like vividly, and then you see it in reality and you've been there. I've never had that happen to me before. If you could leave a comment down below, if you've had something like that happen, let me know like the details about that story. I'd be really interested to know. Okay, that's enough of that. I'm gonna try like deal with this, and then let's make the video about the paper. Check this thing out, man. It'll chop your freaking arm off. It'll chop your bloody arm off. And that, folks, is how it's done. Primus sucks. See you later, Ed.
Yeah.
I just got to my parents' house. This is the street that I grew up on. And it is super windy here today. I want to try and get a cool shot of coming down the street and flying into the house. I don't know how reasonable that is considering how high the wind is right now, but I'm gonna try it. Let's see.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey. This is my boy.
My sunshine.
Wait,
my
is that me? Sunshine. Look, mom's making me chicken adobo.
Ooh, if you don't know what chicken adobo is, you're missing out. If you were invited here, you didn't get any. Oh, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're home.
I'm home.
Yeah, I'm glad. That's good.
I've got a question for you.
Yeah, I'm supposed to be asking you the questions.
No.
Yeah. Yeah, because I'm your mom.
My question for you is...
Is it a hard one?
Maybe.
Okay. I might have to think about it.
What would you do if somebody gave you a winning lottery ticket? If you won the lottery, what would you... let's say $5
million. Like $5 million.
What would you do?
I'd retire... Oh, no, I already did. fix up this house for one thing.
You know, I'm going to repeat that laugh. That was a pretty good one.
I have more coming. There's a lot of them in here. Just listen. Oh, what would... $5 million lottery ticket. Gosh, like fix up this house, buy you guys a place to live. I don't know. I don't know what else I would do. Travel a lot. Spend some more time in Belgium with your sister. Spend more time with you guys. I would be doing what I'm doing now pretty much, except we need a new floor and new cabinets. And whatnot. But other than that, maybe make this house a little bigger. So when you guys came to visit, there'd be lots of room. Although we do have a nice patio now. So that's not much. I don't know if I need $5 million. Are you asking a lot of people this, or did you buy one?
A few people, yeah, and I did buy one, yeah. The whole title of the vlog is going to be what I'm going to do with my winning lottery. We don't know if it won yet or not, to be fair. We're going to find out tonight. Any of you guys remember Slim? This is Slim. This is my dad's Tarahumara Mountain King Snake. He's pretty sweet. My dad loves red on snakes. This guy, he's got red.
What's up, man?
Okay, so I got this theory. Well, I'm doing this video. Happy. I'm doing this video on the title's basically like, what would you do? What I'm going to do with this winning lottery ticket? I know you've always had this theory, or you've always told me this theory about you have. What does he always say? You always say
For lotteries?
Yeah, for lotteries.
It's a Stanford statistician saying you have the same chance of winning whether you play or not.
Well, you're right. That's the one.
Okay.
So, my argument against that theory is in my head is always...
Somebody wins.
Somebody wins, right. Your chances of winning are better if you play than if you don't play.
Statistically, no. It doesn't matter. Well, it depends on how many people are participating. Some lotteries, if there's like 10 people, yeah, you got a 10% chance of winning. But for like the big ones, the $1 million lotteries, effectively those kind of odds... are effectively the same as playing or not playing. You have the same chance. So it depends on the lottery, yeah. If it's a door prize, yeah, you got a pretty good shot at it, as much as the other 20 people in the room. But when you're talking about hundreds of millions, effectively, you have about the same chance whether you play or not.
So what would you do with the ticket if you... If I won the lottery,
yeah. I would definitely take it. I wouldn't say, well, I might as well have lost. It's the same thing. No, it's a different. If you win, you win.
What would you do, though, if you won? Do you have any idea? What you
would do? Take it. Take the money.
Thank you. we're gonna go to the top of this hill. Maybe. Maybe we're gonna go to the top of this hill. I don't know if you can see the brown sky in the background. A fire. A fire has lit here in California. And there's high winds combined with that, so hopefully it's not too bad for the people that are really close to the fire, because high winds and a fire are never good for anybody. Hey, Nugget.
Hey, brother.
What would you do if you won the lottery? If you won $5 million, what would you do with it?
What would I, I would pay off my house and my parents' house. I'd probably buy something cool for my siblings. And I'd stop working. It'd be fantastic.
What's something cool?
Well, it depends on how nice you are to me, and then I'll decide what cool thing you might get. Is that what you're worried about? What cool thing am I gonna get? If I had enough money, I would buy each of my family members a house, for sure. I mean, that's legit. If you have a place to live, then, you know, you're on your own for food, but at least you won't have to sleep outside. You're welcome.
So we need to get up there. All right, we're at the top. Made it. Got the ticket. Gonna check it on the phone. And as I mentioned this morning, I'll tell you what I would do if we win with this ticket is quite selfish. I would give money back to things that I enjoyed, the things that I like, charities and whatnot that I really like and that I think are good things, which that doesn't sound selfish. The selfish part is that I would open up some kind of reptile facility down on the Central Coast where I could bring all my friends who know about reptiles and care about reptiles. We could all work there, and I could bring everybody to where I'm at so we could all hang out all the time, and we could work with reptiles and educate the public about all that kind of stuff and just have fun all the time. Is that selfish?
Are you asking me?
Yeah, I'm asking you.
I don't think the people who would enjoy that would think it's selfish. Yeah. I want a house, damn it. At least a boat, that's cheaper, right? I mean, come on. You could bring your snake on the boat.
Snakes on a boat.
Snakes on the boat.
All right, let's check this thing. You need to hit the power number to win big. And power number is 25. We didn't hit any power number. Now the next number is 50. We have no 50s.
Wait, I see a 25.
Yeah, but it has to be over here on the power number.
Oh, got it.
And then
I don't know how to play.
And then 42. We've got 142 here, but it doesn't mean anything by itself. 34. We don't have a 34. We don't have a 28. We don't have a 26. One number on the entire thing matches one of the numbers here. So, no win today. But
maybe tomorrow.
Maybe tomorrow.
The loneliest,
it's all right.
Number.
I'm not going to cry about it.
Tomorrow is only a day away.
It's all right, guys. We're going to win one of these days. And if we don't win at this, we'll win at something else. And maybe even without winning this, we'll still get to have our dreams come true and build a facility and have everybody come to the Central Coast so I can stop driving everywhere. 500 miles I put in today. I'm done. Let's go home.
It's gonna start overflowing.
You got problems, bro.
It's Cody's birthday. We're celebrating. We've
even got cake. Look at that.